Welcome to SSC Electrical. Today our topic is illumination MCQ. In the previous video we have discussed illumination nodes, so based on that we are going to discuss some MCQ on that. See here, this is the first question. Light is consists of electromagnetic waves. Light consists of electromagnetic waves, very important. Radiant efficiency of luminous source depends on temperature of the source. Radiant efficiency of luminous source depends on temperature of the source. If the temperature of the source is more, it will radiate into longer distance and it will radiate into all directions. So temperature of the source should be more for getting more efficiency. A substance which changes its electrical resistance when illuminated by light is called photoconductive. Material which reflects all the wavelengths in spectrum of light appears to be black to white. If absorbs completely means it is black, reflecting means it is white. So black to white is the answer for this question. An object which appears red to the eye, it reflects the red radiation, so it absorbs the remaining all radiations. So answer will be all of the above. So it absorbs the violet radiation, blue radiation and green radiations and reflects the red radiation. So answer is all of this for this question. Next, the sensors in the eye are known as rods and cones are the sensors in our eye. It comes in physics. Okay, this question can be covered in physics. So next question is, the color temperature of daylight is 600 kelvins. And after this video, if anyone need the PDF, please inform. I will give you the PDF also if anyone need. See the next question. Sky appears to be blue due to scattering of light over dust particles. So answer is D. The color of temperature of daylight is 600 kelvins. Color of light depends on not only on wavelength, it also depends on frequency. So answer is B and C. The wavelength of 5500 angstroms will give a light of yellow green color. 5500 yellow green color, just remember this. Which of the following color has a wavelength between blue and yellow? So as per the vidya, between blue and yellow is green is there. So answer is green. Luminous flux, the rate of energy radiated in the form of light waves, the part of light energy radiated by sun that is received on the earth measured in lux. Luminous flux is rate of energy radiated in the form of light waves, part of light radiated by sun that is received on the earth measured in lux. So answer will be rate of energy radiated in the form of light waves or electromagnetic waves. So answer is A. And in this case it can be measured in lux also, so options given is wrong. You should give all of the above for this. Next, so answer should be for this, if all of the above given, just we need to choose all of the above. Okay, candle power is luminous flux emitted by source per unit solid angle, light radiating capacity of source in given direction, unit of illumination. So candle power is definitely a unit of illumination, so this point is correct. And light radiating capacity of source in a given direction, so this point also correct. Luminous flux emitted by source per unit solid angle, so these two points also correct. So answer should be you should give none of these. If he is asking specifically the definition of that, we need to choose a yes answer. If he is asking the definition, we need to choose yes as the answer. Candle power is luminous flux emitted by a source per unit solid angle. So if all of the above given, A and C is the correct and B also correct, he will give the D option. So both these two questions are something wrong, he need to give D option also, which is all of this. The glare is used due to, glare is used due to excessive luminance, excessive lighting contrast in the field of vision, either A or B. So answer is either A or B. Glare means excessive luminance producing more light, excessive lighting contrast in the field of vision. So both A and B is the answer. So any of the can be the answer. Okay, a perfect diffuser surface is on that, very important. This is repeating question. Transmits all the incident light, absorbs all the incident light, diffuses all the incident light. Answer is not diffuses all the incident light, answer is all of the above. Transmits all the incident light, absorbs all the incident light and diffuses all the incident light. Answer is D. 310. The illumination at a surface due to source of light placed at a distance D from a surface area is. So this question we discussed in previous video also, that is illumination equals to candle power by D square. So from that formula we can say that illumination is inversely proportional to the D square. So answer is A. The illumination at various points on horizontal surface illuminated by same source varies as. Illumination at various points on a horizontal surface illuminated by same source varies as cos cube theta. In the previous video we did a derivation for this, for which we got E is proportional to cos cube theta. You can refer the previous video or the PDF also provided, you can go through that. And that was covered in Lambert's cosine law. We have discussed Lambert's cosine law. In that we did a derivation, E equals to I by D square into cos theta. So after the final derivation we got the equation as E equals to I by H square into cos cube theta. Equal to I by H square into cos cube theta. So from that equation we said that E is proportional to cos cube theta. So from that equation we are saying this cos cube theta is answer. Next, 312. Carbon arc lamps are commonly used in, carbon arc lamps are commonly used in cinema projectors. Carbon arc lamps are generally used in cinema projectors. So A is the answer. Fine diameter tungsten wire is made by wire drying. Just remember this, fine diameter, just diagram fine, just remember like that, diagram fine. So it was well drawn, so wire drying is the answer. Again I'm repeating, fine diameter tungsten wire made by wire drying. The melting point of tungsten is basically, it is 3500 degrees centigrade. If it is given by nearby value, we need to choose that. In this case he has given 3400 degrees centigrade, so we need to choose this. In most of the cases he is not giving the exact value, nearby value is giving, so we need to choose accordingly. The melting point of tungsten is 3400 degrees centigrade. So based on the melting point of tungsten, one more question also asking, that is what is a safe melting point, that is a safer value of tungsten. The safer melting point of the tungsten is 3000 degrees centigrade. Safer melting point of tungsten is 3000 degrees centigrade. Okay, the vacuum inside incandescent lamp is the order of, the vacuum inside a incandescent lamp is order of 10 power minus 8 mmHg. So D is the answer for this. The rate of evaporation of tungsten filament in a lamp depends on, the rate of evaporation of tungsten filament in a lamp depends on, we can see here, vapor pressure. If the vapor pressure is more, so the rate of evaporation tungsten filament will increase. the rate of evaporation of tungsten filament in a lamp depends on vapor pressure. So based on vapor pressure only, the rate of evaporation of tungsten depends. Heat from the lamp filament is transmitted to surrounding mainly through, so you can see in just wait 2 seconds. So we are discussing 317th question. What it is? Let me check. Heat from lamp filament is transmitted to the surrounding mainly through radiation. So based on the radiation only, heat is getting transmitted from filament lamp. So that is the 317th answer. And see the 318th question. So answer is radiation for this. Which of the following material is most commonly used for the filament in incandescent lamp? In incandescent lamp, which filament is used? Answer is tungsten filament. We use this. The 0 watt lamp consumes power of. Answer is not 0 watt. 0 watt lamp consumes 5 to 10 watts. Very very important. A safe operating temperature of tungsten filament lamp is 3000 degrees centigrade. We have discussed just before. The question asked is the melting point of tungsten filament lamp is 3500 degrees centigrade. If you ask it for safe operation of temperature means 3000 degrees centigrade. The output of tungsten filament depends on temperature of the filament. So this kind of question we discussed in the starting question, starting first 5 questions. This kind of question came. What percent of input energy radiated by the filament? So basically filament lamp generally have very less efficiency, so 10 to 15% of the produced input is just radiated from the filament lamp. So 10 to 15 is the answer for this. An electric bulb when broken produces bang. It is an account of. So it produces a huge sound when it is bang due to vacuum inside the bulb. When it is broken, so outside air will tries to come occupy that vacuum space, so that is why the sound will come at that time. That's a bang. So answer is vacuum inside the bulb. An incandescent lamp birdcage filament is usually used in vacuum bulb so as to give uniform radiation. When we use birdcage filament inside an incandescent lamp, we get a uniform radiation. So answer is B. Filament lamps normally operates at a power factor of unity power factor. Very important this is. Filament lamp operates nearly at unity power factor. Most affected parameter of filament lamp due to variation in operating voltage is. Most affected parameter of filament lamp due to variation in operating voltage is life. So the voltage drop occurs sometimes we can observe this. Voltage suddenly increasing, so this kind of variation occurs continuously means it will get affected the life of the filament lamp. Very important. 2 times repeated so far. In previous case also same question came. The lumens output of incandescent lamp with the variation in operating voltage is given as a lumens output is proportional to V power N. So where N is a constant, the value of N for tungsten is, for tungsten the V power N value is 3 to 4. This is also the one derivation is there. Based on that we get an equation. From that equation we derive this. We can say this lumens output is proportional to V power N. So N is 3 to 4. Which gas is sometimes used in filament lamps? Which gas is sometimes used in filament lamps? In filament lamps we use a nitrogen. 329. Which of the following vapor gas will give yellow color in a filament lamp? Which of the following vapor gas will give yellow color in filament lamp? So magnesium will give, sorry, which of the following will give a yellow color in filament lamp? Answer is sodium. 330. Magnesium vapor in a filament lamp gives green color light. Magnesium vapor in a filament lamp gives green color light. Important, just remember this. Magnesium vapor in a filament lamp gives green color in light. The gas used in a gas filled filament lamp is, the gas used in gas filled filament lamp is nitrogen. The gas used in gas filled filament lamp is nitrogen is the answer. In a filament lamp, coiled coil filament are used in gas filled lamp. Same kind of question. In a filament lamp, coiled coil filaments are used in gas filled lamps. 3 remaining questions I will discuss in the next video. Thank you. Thanks for watching this video. Please like the video and share it with your friends. Thank you.